Aloha, my name is Professor Adriano D. Imperato. I'm the founder of the Kajukenbo Self-Defense Institute, Incorporated, in the state of Hawaii. Aloha, and welcome to the first in a series of instructional tape on the traditional method of Kajukenbo. Today, you're able to study directly from high-ranking instructors that are knowledgeable of the original and traditional techniques of the Kajukenbo system. It is my wish that all instructors and students learn these techniques so that we might standardize the system from white to black belt. Therefore, I have given my blessing to Sifu Gary Forbach, a 5th-degree black belt in the Kajukenbo system, to produce this series of instructional videotapes and to let it be known that these are the original, traditional, and pure techniques I've taught them to his master, the late Grandmaster Alejo Reyes. Good luck with your training and always work hard at it. Mahalo and aloha.
Series of instructional videotapes on the Kajukenbo system of self-defense. My name is Gary Forbach and I'll be guiding you through these techniques. This tape contains punching counters number 1 through 21A, approximately 40 techniques. As you can see and as I explained in the grab art tape, the techniques are executed from a standing position. There's a brush block with the left hand, a bottom fist strike to the bicep with the right, and a right forward snapping kick to the groin, simultaneously performed, as you can see. As your opponent comes into punch, you redirect the motion of his punch with the left hand, stun his bicep with the right bottom fist, and kick the groin all at the same time. The lateral movement with the left hand redirects the direction of the punch. Kicks brought back in and step back into a forward stance for balance and control. As you can see, control your opponent's balance as you step back, upsetting his balance, keeping your back straight. The brush block is performed at the wrist. With the palm of the hand, bicep strike is with the bottom fist, kick to the groin is with the ball of the foot, and then you take control of your opponent. Punching counter number 2. Again, you have the blocking, stunning, and kick simultaneously performed as in number 1 with a back fist to the temple, outward block crossing over and stepping into a cover position. As you can see, the back fist is executed before the foot's put down in front. The block and the crossover are executed at the same time. Stunning strike, block and kick, back fist to the head, crossing over, blocking simultaneously. Stepping out with the left foot, back with the right into your cover position. As you can see, the block, the outward block, is performed above the elbow. This turns your attacker's body away from you, not allowing him to counter with a circling back fist. As mentioned before, and in all Kajukenbo techniques, they're done with speed, power, and accuracy. Punching counter 2A. As before, the block, strike to the bicep and kick are performed, crossing over, kicking to the ribs with the left, roundhouse kick to the solar plexus with the right while you're holding the opponent's wrist, stepping out, crossing over, and covering. Stunning, back fist, kick, kick, cross over, and cover. As you can see, the right leg is suspended until after the back fist. The right hand slides down your opponent's wrist. Thrust kick to the ribs. Stepping down, placing your foot at an angle, holding on with your right. Roundhouse kick to the solar plexus or sternum. Cross over in front with your right foot. Stepping back and into your cover position. Punching counter number 3. Again, the back fist to the bicep, blocking the wrist and kicking the groin simultaneously, dropping your opponent down by folding his arm at the elbow, controlling him and dropping into a horse stance, holding against his arm, pushing underneath the armpit and holding the arm with the right, left snapping kick up under the armpit, stepping back into a cover position. Striking, dropping, turning him, and kicking. It's very important to remember, as you lower your center of balance and your opponent's balance, you keep their body down as you're kicking. Don't allow them to go up because you lose power in the kick. All kicks are performed with the ball of the foot into the groin, drop, pivoting your body into a forward stance, kicking, covering. Punching counter 3A. Again, your opening sequence bicep strike, block, and kick to the groin. Before placing your right foot down after your first kick, you'll notice there's a chop to the side of the neck, grabbing the gi, throwing them, crossing over, back fist, the lower back, the middle of the back, and the base of the skull. Grab your opponent's head, lifting up. It's a shudo up underneath the nose, raking the eyes, and a palm heel strike to the back of the head, forcing their face into the ground. Chop, grab, throw, cross over, back fist, one, two, three. Grab the hair, lift, strike, rake, poke. As I said before, you leave the foot up in the air as you throw your opponent back, using it for momentum. Crossing over, striking as you land. And completing the technique, back to cover position. Punching counter number four. Beginning technique, chop and grab. Take down with the right leg, pulling your opponent's leg back, pushing the shoulder down. It's a takedown, arm bar over your knee, and a double strike. In practice, we strike to the chest. On the street, we strike to the throat. Take down. Bringing the arm back over your knee, chopping once, twice to the throat, chest in practice, stepping back and covering. Striking, switching the feet, bringing the right leg up, sweeping the leg out, dropping the opponent down, controlling his arm, his right arm. The knee goes into the throat, arm bar, striking once, twice, back to a cover position. Punching counter number 4A. The beginning of 4A is similar to number 4, to the takedown position. This time you're going to control the arm by bringing both your hands up to his wrist to hold his wrist. A forward kick into the back of the ribs, a heel kick into the chest, wrapping your leg around his arm in front and underneath his head to control him in an armbar position. Opening technique, switching the legs. The leg sweep, as he goes out, control his arm, kicking the ribs, the sternum, wrapping the foot around his arm and behind his head, stepping out, bending the arm into a shoulder lock, snapping kick to the head, step back and cover. Wrist lock, kick to the ribs, heel to the chest, wrapping the foot around behind the head, switching the grip with your left hand so that you're cupping his thumb I slide my hand up to his elbow and pull his wrist back, pushing down on the elbow. Have total control over your opponent. Extremely effective restraining technique. Snapping kick to the head and cover. 1, 2, wrap around, arm bar. Chop and grab. If you'll notice the switching of the hands, left hand switches to cup to yoke the thumb. Kick to the head. Stepping back at cover position. Punching counter number 5. As you can see, the beginning of number 5 is a little bit different. You're stepping to your left on a 45 degree angle, getting out of the way of the punch. Putting your hands together, right over left. Trapping the hand, stepping back and behind your foot with a forward stance, twisting his arm into an arm bar, strike the elbow, chop the neck, grab the shoulder, pull him back into you, step back, thrust kick into the groin or the sternum, step back and then step through with your elbow while still holding on, letting him go, pushing him down to the ground, step back and cover. Grabbing, twisting, controlling with your left, striking with the right, stepping back while still gripping on to his shoulder, pushing off, stepping back and cover. Try not to forget, after you throw your kick, remember to step back. Stepping back, pulling him into you, kicking, stepping back again to regain balance, push off, and drop him back to cover position. Punching counter number 5, A. The beginning of 5A is exactly the same as 5. Back to this point where you don't drop your foot back down, you take your opponent down to your right side. After the kick, leave your foot up and turn him. Watch slowly. Step to the side, trap the hand, twist him down, arm lock, strike, chop, grab, same as 5, stepping back, kicking, leaving your knee up, lifting his arm up and over, taking him down on his back. Your knee is on his left arm, your right forearm is choking across his throat because of your grip. Your grip is on his right hand or on his right shoulder. And as you take him down, you're twisting him over. And now you've still got the grip on the right shoulder. And you're able to choke your opponent with your forearm. As you can see, I'm grabbing the right shoulder. After the takedown, I continue my grab and force my arm down over the throat, holding the opponent and also holding the left hand with my left hand. Back fist, step up and cover. Strike to the bicep, chop the neck, grab. Kick and twist. Drop your body right down on your opponent. You can see the right knee is on trapping his arm. Holding my left hand is holding his right arm, and then a back fist, stepping up and covering. Punching counter number 6. This technique is extremely effective. As your opponent steps in to punch, you step to your left to 2 o'clock. I'm sorry, 10 o'clock. With your left leg into a forward stance, upward block with the right, circle around, trapping his hand, circling around, and raking across his eyes with your right hand, with your fingers. After raking, circling as you can see, raking across, step out with the left, roundhouse kick with the right to the sternum or solar plexus, crossing over, and covering. Step and block, circle, rake the eyes, roundhouse kick, cross over in front, stepping out and covering. Punching counter number 6A. 6A begins as 6 did, but instead of raking the eyes, as you can see, I trap the arm with my left, step around, circling my opponent, circling and up and under the arm, trapping the arm, stepping my body, does a 360-degree turn, pulling my opponent around off balance. And as I bring him around, I chop the back of the neck with my right hand and knee with my right knee. Blocking, circling, slipping my left arm up and under, striking the ribs with the right hand, grabbing, circling around with my foot, stepping, pulling him off balance, chop and knee at the same time. The knee goes to the chest, the chop goes to the neck, like a guillotine. As I said before, it's an extremely effective technique, but in all techniques, got to use speed, power, and accuracy. Punching counter number 7. If you'll remember, in number 5, you step to your left, turn your body, trap the hand. This time you're circling the hand, circling his arm up, kicking up into the stomach or solar plexus, dropping your right knee down to the ground and bringing your forearm down behind the shoulder, dropping your opponent straight down into an armbar takedown. Twisting, kicking immediately. Dropping and restraining. As you can see, as the opponent comes down, that's the time to get your timing down on your kick. Forcing him down, and I'm down on my right knee, restraining him with an armbar over my left knee. Punching counter number 7A. As in number 7, you're stepping to your left, but instead of going right over left with your hands to trap, your hands go left over right, taking your opponent the opposite direction, exposing him, kicking to the groin, crossing over in front, striking the bicep, chopping the neck with a wrist lock and an arm takedown, dropping him down, stepping back and covering. Trap left over right, twist, groin kick, strike, chop, straight takedown, and cover. You can see it's very important to remember that when you're doing your takedown, you have extremely good control of the wrist. And when you're performing the takedown, You don't make a long wide arch with your opponent. Take him straight down in front of you. But I recommend in practice, especially beginning students, you take extreme care in not overdoing on your techniques. Always remember, the person that's helping you practice is your friend, and they're helping you. You should always respect that. Never try to injure your fellow student. Wrist lock. Kick to the groin or solar plexus. Strike. Chop. Wrist lock. Takedown. Punching counter number 8. As you can see, in number 8, you step to the left, out of the way of the attack, with a brush block with your left hand and a strike, a chop across the ribs with the right, going in opposite direction. The brush block comes in, blocking his wrist or his hand in towards him to the inside, chop and strike. Twisting your body, pushing the shoulder down with your left, stepping around, striking with the right, chopping in the back of the neck with the right, and grabbing your opponent by the collar and also by the belt or pants or whatever he happens to have on, and then you execute a knee to the head or to the chest, and knee. Simultaneous, the block and the strike, chop, push down, the chop and the switching of the legs. As you can see, my right knee's back, grab, take control, knee to the face, down and cover. Punching counter number 8A. Exactly the same movement as number 8, but before pushing down with your left hand, pushing the shoulder down, you strike with your index knuckle to the sternum and the spine with both hands, both the right and the left hand. Then you push your opponent down, switching your feet and knee, just as in number 8. Here we go. Strike, push down, chop and switch, grab, and knee. Step back and cover. Simultaneous blocks, simultaneous strikes. Force them down, chop, knee. Punching counter number 9. Step straight in with your left foot, upward block, and strike the groin. As I said before, from a standing position, upward block, step in with the left, and strike the groin with the right simultaneously. In slow motion. Simultaneously, block, strike, and step. Step in with the right, uppercut the chin, knee to the groin, cross over, chop the ribs, chop the neck, and a side kick to another attacker. This is a two-man attack technique, basically. Strike, uppercut, knee, chop, side kick. Uppercut, knee, crossover and chop, side kick and chop. Punching counter number 9A, same opening, strike, block, and kick. Crossover, chop and grab the groin, forcing your opponent back down over your knee as you cross over into horse stance, dropping him down over your knee. Watch closely, crossover. Crossover and strike the groin, the throat, and grab. Step out with the left, controlling your opponent. Slamming down over your knee, breaking the back. Lifting up with the knee, forcing him up. Let him go. Punch the ribs. Step back and cover. Grab and chop, take down, drop, punch. Striking the throat causes your opponent to fall back off balance, and as you cross over, his weight being off balance drops him right down over your knee. That's why it's very important to get proper positioning behind your opponent with your left foot into a horse stance. Lift, break. Punch and cover. Punching counter number 10. This technique is known as a football carry or football takedown. Left brush block, right strike to the ribs as you're stepping with the left into a forward stance. Block and strike. Reach behind his leg, your opponent's leg, with your left hand. Elbow the ribs with your right forearm as you're stepping in simultaneously with the right foot. Sliding in between the legs. Opening up the groin, dropping down. For control, striking with the right, then the left. Grab the ankle. Strike the ankle bone. Throw the leg over. Step in, holding the arm back and down. And cover. It's very important that you remember not to pull your attacker's leg up between your legs when you're taking him down. That can happen, so you have to be very careful to make sure that as you're taking your opponent down, that you guide his leg outside of your left leg. At this point here, slide in between the legs for control. Drop down, spreading the legs, ripping the muscles, strike the groin. Then the ankle. Controlling the arm, opening the ribs. Bust the ribs. Step back and cover. Punching counter number 11. From a standing position, left long outward block with an open hand, poking with the right hand to the eyes, forward snapping kick to the groin with the right, all at the same time. Step back out with your right foot, side kick with the left, cross over, and cover. Block and strike, kicking at the same time. Stepping back as he comes in again. Side kick. Crossover and cover. Punching counter number 12. As you can see, there's similar movements in all of these techniques, but they're used and taught for various situations, different situations and different circumstances. Step in with the left, upward block with the left, and strike down and rake with the right. Strike with the groin with your right hand. Step in, grab behind both legs, pushing again with your head, taking your opponent down, opening the legs up, double strike to the groin with the right, the left, strike the ankle, throw the arm over, or I'm sorry, the foot, step in, punch to the ribs, step back and cover. Strike and rake, strike, step in, headbutt and pull at the same time, strike, strike. The ankle, control, and punch. Punching counter number 13. Outward block with the left, punch with the right, right forward snapping kick, crossing over, stepping back and a right side snapping kick, stepping back and covering. Simultaneous block, strike and kick, crossing over, side kick with the right. Covering. First kick is a snapping kick to the groin. Stepping back. Second kick, side thrust kick with the heel. Taking your opponent out, stepping back to cover. Punching counter number 14, 15. These two techniques are done simultaneously. The first part of the technique is the strike and the kick. The right hand strikes inside the wrist. Left hand actually strikes the fist, the bottom of the fist on the punch, doing damage to the wrist so with a forward snapping kick at the same time. Second part of the technique, or number 15, is after you step back, grabbing the throat, blocking with the left, taking your opponent down and controlling with an arm bar and a grip to the throat. Striking the wrists, as you can see, stepping back, blocking, grabbing, pulling down with the left, controlling with the right, getting an armbar restraint, and controlling him with the grip on the throat. Quickest way to control an opponent on the ground is to cut the air off. Punching counter number 16. In this technique, you step to the right. Step to the right, upper block with the left. Strike the groin with the right. Step in, uppercut. Knuckle strike to the tricep. Reaching up, grabbing behind your opponent's neck, behind the gi. Here, strike. Strike, step behind, step around, and throw. Strike, step in, uppercut, grabbing, controlling, both hands grabbing on your opponent's right arm. Take down, arm bar, and break if necessary. Uppercut, tricep, grab. Use your hips to throw your opponent and cover. Strike and block, uppercut, tricep. Watch the positioning of the feet. As I grab, I step back around with my left foot, dropping inside my opponent's balance, lifting with my legs, throwing, and recovering. Always lift with your legs. Punching counter number 17. If you remember number one, simultaneously striking the bicep with the right hand, brush blocking the wrist with the left, snapping kick, slide your arm down, your right arm down to control your opponent, stepping back with your right foot, a forearm strike to the back of the shoulder, forcing your opponent down, drop down on your left knee, controlling your opponent with another arm bar, back to cover. Blocking, striking, kicking, step back with your right and take down, straight down. As you can see, I have good control with an arm bar. Switching the wrists, switching the hands, twisting the body, pivoting, and take down and control. As you can see, I have 3 points of pressure. I'm kneeling on one knee, standing on one foot, and I'm leaning the rest of my weight on my opponent's shoulder, pinning him down. Punching counter number 18 is done from a southpaw position. Your attacker is will be attacking you this time with two punches, a left-right combination, just as a boxer would do. You're standing with your right foot forward, your right hand forward, two brush blocks as you step back, tap once and twice. Step in, kick with the left to the groin, chop with the left, chop with the right, grab, take down an elbow to the face, step back and cover. One, two, kick with the left, step in and chop twice, grab the hair, elbow to the face, and cover. You have to be very accurate on your blocks, not to push, but just to slap. These are brush blocks or slapping blocks. Accuracy is very important on these techniques, especially the chops to the side of the neck. They should be performed high on the neck. Grab, twist your body back to your right, pulling with your right hand, pulling the hair, elbow in the face, and dropping straight down. Punching counter number 19. 19 is probably one of the most simple but effective techniques in the Kajukenbo system. As you'll notice, I step back to the right, moving back at an angle to my right, a 45 degree angle, side kick with the left, cross over in front with the left, stepping out and covering. As the opponent comes in with a punch, I step back, drawing him off balance. And as his arm is extended, as he throws his punch, side kick comes under. Punching counter number 20. Again, another simple technique. Fade back. Kick with the right to the groin. Pivot without dropping the foot. And roundhouse kick to the head. Step back and cover. Groin, head. Extending in before the attacker is able to punch. And kicking the head. Punching counter number 21. Another simple technique, drop into the left to a kneeling position. Roundhouse kick to the groin with the ball of the foot. Drop to your left, roundhouse kick, step up and cover. Drop, kick, cross over. And recover. On the street, the kick is executed to the groin. In practice, we practice to the solar plexus. Punching counter number 21A. 21A begins exactly like 20, but after you throw your roundhouse kick, spring up from the ground, switch your stance in midair, kick with the left foot either to the ribs or to the head if it's in position for contact. Drop and kick, spring up to the feet and jump, continuing your upward motion, kick with the left to the face and cover. This concludes a series of instructional tapes on punching counters of the Kajukenbo system of self-defense. As I said before, always practice repetitiously and safely. Always practice hard and train hard. Hard training and repetition training is the only way to master any art. As I said, always be relaxed, always be humble, and pay respect to your fellow man. Good luck with your training.